But the last week, once we're going to see bridge breakout against this middle price line over this, you know, short-term blue trend line, we're going to see the bridge breakout on a daily chart basis. But after this, we're going to see sharp drop again. So it can be very volatile price move here. Hi, hello, I'm Samasa. So today is the regular item, Bitcoin weekly forecast and my four updates from May 22nd to May 28th. Okay, so let's start. Then this is my portfolio performance as of now. So total return since March 2019 is 628%. Then if you're interested, much more detailed information about my portfolio allocations and also my real-time buy and selling signal for every single crypto assets, including ICO, IDO, DeFi, and NFT, please think about to join my premium membership program, real-time buy and selling signal. The major purpose of this membership program to help you reach your crypto asset performance to my level here. The for more detail, please check out my video. Here's my video link. Okay. Then let's start here, Bitcoin. Then this is a BTC USDT daily chart. So it's currently kind of a very volatile move happening here. So still the price move itself converging trend. Then in this, you know, trend model, usually we're gonna see, you know, upper price breakout or lower price breakout, either directions. Okay. Then think about, you know, entire market momentum, also upcoming, you know, summer rally moment. I think, you know, higher possibility. I think upper price breakout get the much higher possibility here. Okay. But the last week, once we're going to see bridge breakout against this middle price line over this, you know, short-term blue trend line, we're going to see the bridge breakout on a daily chart basis. But after this, we're going to see sharp drop again. So it can very volatile price move here. But the still, you know, once the price hit purple line here, which is actually zero level at the Fibonacci Butters base point, we're gonna see price reversal actions. Okay? Then also long-term red trend line, as I show you like this way, also function like support line. So still it's a bridge trend. So, you know, kind of a middle moment for the, you know, bottoming out of these, you know, entire price move here. Okay? Then based on this current broader asset move, I set a certain period of time for the bottoming out or next bridge line from now to end of June to beginning of the July. As I mark here in the red circle, that's what I'm thinking about. Okay. Then of course the key mission for this in bottoming out is they need to bridge breakout against this upper line of this blue bear trend line. Okay. Then why I set end of June to beginning of July, because these red trend line price bottom formations and upper price line, which is this blue bear trend line, crossing between end of June to beginning of July. That's why. So this is my kind of a longest scenario for the bottoming out. Then of course, before that, we might see bridge breakout. Okay, so but you know, I set the around like in a 1 month time frame for here. Then next up, it's S&P 500 futures. So why Bitcoin is kind of volatile right now? I think, you know, that price is throwing up, you know, S&P 500 again. That's what I'm thinking about. So which means that, you know, once S&P goes bullish, BTC also goes bullish. Okay, so no decoupling yet in this market. Then current S&P, these, you know, parallel thick blue trend line function like a key resistance line, as you can see. But I think stock market goes to the thick green trend line, throwing up the long-term bullish trend. That's what I'm thinking about. The EMA 200 still under the candle bar price move. This is also pretty good. So I think it's still bullish trend line is continuing. Okay. Then one of the reason we're gonna see the bullish line last week is because this one, quarter one earning call, especially Nvidia hit a pretty, you know, big surprise here. That was pretty good. Then next one, WTI crude oil, still under bearish move, but you know, still the thick green trend line around $62 function like a pretty strong resistance line. It's for sure. Okay. Then next one, FRB, FFR rate. Still FRB set that 5.25%. Then current interest rate set as 4.83%. their inflation rate still keep hovering around, you know, 4% or 5% or so, I do think FRB, they're going to hike their interest rates again, I think. Then which bring us much more serious trouble on the U.S. banking industry again. That's the things we have to remember that. Then that's also, you know, accelerate breach line of the Bitcoin and Ethereum or other high potential, you know, altcoins. Okay. Then there's some U.S. 10-year treasury interest rates. So this is the kind of key topic we have to pay attention to because currently we're going to discussing about technical default of U.S. government. It's kind of the serious problem right now because of this, you know, interest rates of the U.S. 10-year treasury bond hit a pretty strong move here, okay? Then here's a key topic we have to pay attention to. So what happens to Bitcoin and Ethereum if the U.S. defaults on its debt? But first of all, the key point is, you know, I think we can avoid, you know, the real scenario of the U.S., you know, government default. Because once we're going to experience this, you know, actual U.S. government defaults, our world economy into chaos. I would say we might experience this World War III. All right, because, you know, China, Russia are still looking for, like, you know, downtrend of the U.S. economy or society or their political power for the, you know, global, like, international business stuff. So from this perspective, you know, we might experience a certain level of, you know, pretty high, you know, travel, serious travel for the World War III, right? So from this perspective, I think we can avoid it. But the short-term technical default might happen. Because, you know, as far as U.S. Congress never approved after the debt ceiling of the U.S. government bonds, U.S. government has no money to pay their interest rates. That is why they have to, you know, put the upper side, you know, lift their, you know, debt ceiling of the U.S. government bonds. But still, it takes time to convince the Congress and the U.S. government. So, you know, that's why we're going to see this kind of broader environment still, you know, continuing right now. Then in that case, of course, you know, in such kind of like the short term, you know, U.S. government bond default, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and other high potential altcoin goes bullish. It's pretty sure. Okay. Then there's some U.S. inflation rates. Next update, June 13th. Again, so currently 4.9%. So this is the kind of key, you know, stats right now we have to pay attention to because it's still the U.S. unemployment rate is very stable. That's why only inflation is, you know, pretty big risk for us. So, you know, U.S. initial jobless claim here is no big change here. Then, you know, U.S. unemployment rate this week, June 2nd, is update timing. I think it's still stable. Stable. So, you know, only we have to pay attention to U.S. inflation rates. That's what I'm thinking about. Okay? Then there's some BTC transaction fee. May 28th, 4.88. 7-day change, minus 20%. Still kind of stable. Okay? Then most people argue that what's the reason why, you know, the transaction fee skyrocket happened on the Bitcoin market? My analysis here is because of this. China, again. Because then usually, here's a big language barrier, you know, inside the Chinese economy or society stuff. That is why it's kind of a little delayed. We're going to see that, you know, what kind of things, you know, really happening here inside the Chinese economy, right? Then it looks like, you know, recently, you know, China government, you know, broadcasted that the Hong Kong is allowing to, you know, retail investors to buy Bitcoin again, right? Also, you know, the Beijing leases white paper for Web3 innovation and developments. I think this is one of the major topics why we're going to see the huge skyrocket on BTC gas fee, transfer fee. Because, you know, most of the, you know, BTC transaction inside of China is offline. You know, not a central exchange or DEX. Usually, they're going to use an OTC trading, right? Face-to-face trading stuff. So from this perspective, you know, but still in this, you know, face-to-face trading stuff, we're going to see, you know, skyrocket of BTC transaction volume. So from this perspective, this gas fee increase is kind of to me natural. That's why we don't see any kind of big price move here on the Bitcoin itself during this, you know, skyrocket with gas fee. So this is my guess, okay? Then there's an all market cap and BTC dominant slates. Total market cap, minus 0.5%, almost no change. The BTC dominant slates, 46.2% compared to last week is minus 0.07%. Also almost no move here last week, okay? Then there's some for a backup analysis, we're going to check out ETH BTC weekly chart basis. Then here also very critical moments on weekly chart basis. They are also forming converging trend All right, long term is still bullish, following up the Z's red trend line, and the bottom trend line is a sick. The bottom trend line is a sick blue trend line. But in parallel, you know, we're gonna see the short term bear trend line, blue line here. Then now it's converging, right? Then I do think still this, you know, blue trend line functions like a pretty strong key support line. Is BTC market trend, right? Then EMA 200, still under the price move, candle bar price move, this is also pretty good. So from this perspective, I think we're gonna see this pretty strong bridge breakout from here. That's what I'm thinking about, okay? Then this is also kind of little key news. It's pretty interesting. Dow Treasury surges from 8.8 billion to 21.5 billion in 19 days, while making a 144% rise. This is impressive. So this is the background data here. So the key point, I want you to understand here that these days, we're gonna see the huge growth of the altcoin, high potential altcoin project. That's why we're gonna see the, you know, Treasury growth here, right? So this is also one of the key signal that from here, we gradually see, you know, the high potential altcoin market cap growth against BTC dominant slates. So from here, my prediction is BTC dominant slates soaring going down, the altcoin going up. Okay, so that's what I'm thinking about. Then there's some Google search trend. BTC, 18, no change. Ethereum, NFT, crypto, also no change. Then usually once BTC hits 16 to 18, this is almost bottom level in the current market momentum. Just like a calm moment before the storm, okay? Then next item, key news updates. So here's the key news updates. Upcoming US big economy events. So US major stock 2023 Q1 earnings call still continuing. Also, you know, US employment report, we're gonna get these updates on June 2nd, okay? This Friday. Then, you know, this is the Q1 earnings call schedule this week. We're gonna have the update from Broadcom, Salesforce, and VMware. Here's the kind of a last slide. What's the key mindset of HODLer? So most people assume that the HODL is like a smooth scenario, upside scenario, but the reality of HODL is bottom side scenario, right? The one of the key points, why don't you understand here that if you wanna gain bigger investment return in Web3 assets, be patient, okay? Then here's the result of HODL. So I do think that the HODL is best for the retail investor to minimize the risk and maximize the return, because investment in Web3 assets, just like investment in early days of Google and Facebook, then once we look at the legendary angel investor traction, such as Long Conway, Peter Thiel, Riedelman, all the time, they get a simple investment approach. It's a long-term investment. Then here is another episode of the Binance Research. This is a Bitcoin case, and the longest holder of Bitcoin also maximize the investment return. In this case, plus 220%, much larger number than other short-term here. Then I'm gonna also basically take a long-term investment approach. So I'm gonna also recommend you guys to take the same approach too, okay? Alright, so that is all this time. So I'm gonna make this video for educational purpose. So I'm not gonna guarantee you any kind of certain double investment outcome with this video and any video that I make. But I truly hope that my video party help you guys understand about high potential about crypto virtual space. So I'm gonna make a lot of in this video crypto virtual space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.